guys any of that information, it's still going to be the same. It's on. Mm-hmm. It's a little
true.
Cards that are blue because that's the color I've got for the guy. There'll be some cars that are hidden that are blue or not going to the docks. And then going back to the docks, it still has a blue color.
I see.
So it's what it'll do for me is that I can see patterns just by what the colors are.
Sure.
What happens is over a period of time, things just tend to get bunched. And, yeah. And I don't know what does it, but sometimes you can
do it. Well, I agree with this. I'm looking through. There's probably 30 cars total. Now, what I did, I did the color coding on my waybills. I'm probably not a good example. I want the SCP stuff, it's all gray, and the gray one, it's all blue wash and stuff. So that was a really wide approach.
Everybody does car cards, so that's a little different.
Oh, yeah. We had a friend of mine who's been running a number of years. He was doing New York Central, but he had cars that would go north and west and the blues would go south. And he was from New York. And so the problem was nobody understood which was which. The pencil just put a red or green dot on the outbound so the yard master could easily go through it. Because that's the thing. Especially with operating control used for layout, they're a little geographical challenge.
Oh, sure. So nobody can memorize all your towns
exactly.
In a matter of a couple of minutes looking at your map.
Exactly. Session turned out because some friends of mine were in California. They wanted to do an intersection. They posted the steep ways and chains. So they posted the map. So I said, sure. In addition to it, I do well. I said, you can do it well. Stage. I have another friend set up to help me stage. I'm going to
do a layout, and so I told him, you guys come up with anomaly lines, so we got to get this thing staged up. So, you know, when I get done staging, if you're still here, I'll be happy to answer your questions.
Sure.
So that was the best I could do. I was going to toss them out. But it was difficult. I wasn't supposed to go through it.
When we did he's really good guy, good friend of mine. He takes the schedule and says, these are the layouts that are operating, these are the layouts that are at the house. But it's all on the same list. I said, Frank, I'm really worried that you're going to show up at my house. Oh, no. You have said for anything. First session on Thursday, the guy raised his hand. I want to come in. Well, hold me up for this session. I'm looking for an open house. Well, you don't mind. I just want to come. Come on. All right. I'm try to be a nice guy. So he comes in, and he looks at me and says, oh, I would have thought you'd have more scenery. So, you know, my first thought is, little girl, blank yourself, right?
Yeah.
And then he looks around, and then I didn't have this on. This was just still exposed.
Uh-huh.
And he goes, oh, yeah, it's okay. So that's something stuff I would do. Do you realize how much of an ass you're being? So.
I one of the dumbest things I ever saw somebody do is just a long time ago. Guy comes down to my basement he put me sitting on my stuff again. And so he starts rattling off his whole roster. You know, in the context of he's visiting my basement, what relevance does that have? So, I just went along with it and nodded and smiled a lot. But, you wonder whether, people don't just, you know, there's certain social skills that, that are not just indicative from all the world. It doesn't take a lot of imagination to conduct yourself well in a circumstance. A lot of people just don't do it.
I agree. Mm-hmm.
You never know which ones they are. I had a guy who came over for Nash. I had 50 guys that operated for Nash.
Wow.
49 of them did a really good job. This guy came over, he emailed me ahead of time going on the other. And so I said, okay, he's probably got the ability to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he must have been a former slot car racer. Because he had two speeds that he operated at. It would be full speed and stop. And so my yard end was running back and forth, banging covers and stuff like that. And so I looked for him and I said, controller working okay for you? I need to turn over the controller. He said, okay, that's working fine. 2 minutes later, I'm going, I need you to work it off the answer. You need to run the other. I decided. I just toughed it out and let it go. But the guys that were operating the rest of the session were not pleased with what was happening in the yards.
Oh, really?
His operation of the yards was just as screwed up as his technical ability. And so I decided from that point on, if anybody ever misbehaves, I'm going to go get two opportunities and I'll send them home in the third. But, you know, it's just, I'm not going to lie to them.
I agree.
Okay.
The guy that says, ooh, I want you.
I'll take a look at it. Yeah, I don't think it's the first buzzer office. We had a guy show up. He never operated it.
Uh-huh.
I mean, yeah, when I put it into the room, first of all, it shows up like how that was the then. No, I got this.
Sure,
you need this? No, I got this. Let me switch two cars and so it's fine. Yeah, so you're standing here going, hello. And the contrast was a guy from Mexico for a same nickname.
What you
got
to get done.
Yep.
And how you do is up to you, the group.
Well, so that's why I like to leave it a simple question. I don't know how to tell you how.
I have the opposite situation. Same convention. This guy shows up with his medical vehicle. So I had to go to the switch and it never got done. And sometimes there's several things. So yeah, I may have 2 days worth of switching down there. I'm just playing by myself.
Nice. So I'm not sure you're in trouble with this. Because you operate it.
Yeah. I've done different job. I can do that job, and this job, and then one in the back room.
Okay. I'll have to look on my spreadsheet. It's not like I like to really rotate in prior jobs
mm-hmm.
before they start.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, so.
Oh, we won't get back until probably the last thing for April 15th. So, yeah, I got your email. I haven't responded yet. I need to coordinate with Kathy and find out what we're doing when. I'll be sure to sign out.
Yeah, well, I'll make sure to get that. And I'll make sure to show
you
one in April before you go. Yeah. Yeah, I wanted to take care of this.
Oh, nice.
Make sure you have two just now.
Yeah, for sure. It's for me, it's the highest part of coming out here, the fact that I think I'm going to break my brain down. What I do is when I can't get something out there, I can't do it for a mask and 2 weeks of just running away all by myself. And it's try to get it out of my system before we come back this way. It never works. You know, you try.
There you go. Well, you're still in this cocktail club, right?
Yeah. I get involved in our operating sessions too. Their operating sessions are something that you need to do. I'm not crazy about trying to go and turn on code switches. We do both.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's one of those things that I'm not sure I would
operate
over here over the
day. Sure. Yeah, about being able to hear his phone like this. Well, you know, you can have sex
then, so. I know, I do. And the section was up there. I don't know if I'm going to do the state contract. Somebody gets hurt
during
the push mode.
Oh, yeah. You're not the looking for it. You know, I was reading, I remember that telling me such a lot. In California, they're actually starting to put local, like that local motor, but then they're looking at the control car.
Oh, yeah.
So that in case they do hit something, the local motor absorbs the impact.
That would be a good thing. So they're actually operating from a dead local motor?
I think they're using the control car behind the locomotive.
Oh.
I may not be 100% accurate, but I know they talked about it because of the simple reason that there is no protection.
Yeah.
Yeah, just compass.